I have HIV AIDS and it's going viral. This is not the first time you guys have been using my pictures for this kind of things. If you want to see racism, just go to Weibo. That is where you're going to see anything about black. They're going to insult us. Anything about black
and Chinese, you don't dare to read the comments because the comments are really disgusting. And I call these people keyboard warriors because I don't care about how people think about me online. I don't really care.
And there's an article that I read that said China says foreigners have HIV AIDS.
Maybe we could just say they really use it the wrong way.
There's something that like a large number of Chinese, they have HIV and AIDS or like the same shit anyways.
No, but I said they use it like the face.
And everything.
Well, first of all, all foreigners do, medical tests before they leave Asia. So
exactly.
I don't know why they keep on accusing us you have HIV.
Foreigners have it in China because they come from Chinese anyways, because whenever we come, we take the test. That's true.
Yeah. Give me some schools, I think it's 6 months,
Yeah.
And some schools also, I think once a year, like once in a while. So, I don't know.
China really took this way too far, and we just came from a meeting at school, a drug meeting. And one of the drugs that is going around is that this drug, the new drug, can give people HIV, and everyone was like, what, are you serious? It can't be true, and it's so stupid. I don't even know. And it's telling us to a bunch of foreigners like, oh, this drug gives you HIV, don't take it. So I don't know if they are associating HIV and AIDS with foreigners in general and black people in general. I don't know why Chinese is doing this. It just doesn't make sense. And it's going way, way, way too far.
All those fucking substances or something, you use the same needle or something, blah, blah, like that, you can't get.
But okay, so are we talking
about... That's how you could get HIV, but yeah. I don't know what that whole drug thing that they're saying.
Well, I think maybe it's because they're Chinese, which is not that great and everything, maybe they didn't know how to express it or something, but that's why I think that's
her English is good. Her English is
good. Oh my god, it's silence from the office. Her English is not good at all. She's an idiot. I know her.
But I don't understand why that Chinese are always trying to paint blacks really bad. Like what they did to Guatemala right now, that he's having HIV.
Because they are racist.
Because they use his pictures of as a couple because they know it will create traction. He's like creating YouTube videos, more people is watching him. And so it's like once they see his picture, everybody automatically reads the headline. What does it say today?
They will never try to see if this is true or not or something. They just read it and that's it. They never check the source or something.
Yeah, you know, like that means like this world called character assassination. Yeah, trying to just painting black, you know.
Right.
And he has worked hard to build a good world about the blank Guatemala.
Mm-hmm.
Right. They are trying to just put it down, you know. Maybe since he started like vlogging and everything now,
right,
he has been touching a lot of big companies and everything over here. So he's gaining a lot of popularity. So they need to bring him down.
In China there are so many cheap hospitals that you go to. Even sometimes when I go to Chichen, I'm scared or something because
the hospitals, some are really good, but you know, example, what we do at medicals, you know,
mm-hmm,
is being designated for us by the school.
Yeah. Right.
So everything that we do, they communicate with the school.
But you see, in other way, I understand the Chinese people also, because some of the schools, they do medical tests every 6 months.
Yeah.
Some schools, they do it once a while.
Or three after you finish school.
So, like, some recently, some case happened in our school,
mm-hmm,
that once a African guy has an HIV,
mm-hmm,
and like, it's going viral, that's true. Yeah. In KG, since I came to China, I've done only one medical test. So if I go home and come back and have an HIV, how would you know?
I think like you as a person, like for your own, I don't know, safety or something, you should do the medical checks, not just because there's content, but because you should do it.
Yeah, that's
right. Check yourself.
Yeah, for that one, I agree with you. And like doing personal checks is also
true. And you know that it's a violation of the client or the doctor like relationship or the contract, everything. If it's a breaking of confidentiality, mm-hmm. because if I'm coming to do a medical checkup and everything, it's a confidential thing that I'm going to discuss HIV AIDS. So if I have HIV AIDS, I think the authorities in my school
shouldn't even know about that.
Because we, like, the school is an institution, they need to know we are here under the, like, the offices of the school. So if I have HIV, they need to prompt the school that, okay, this is what we found about your students and everything. Okay, the school will call me and this, okay, and silence, I will leave it out. So why will you bring it out that
Chinese people will never make this thing silent.
Right, they will never.
Why?
Wow.
Even
it's illegal. It's
illegal. Tuberculosis in our school, some guys have
tuberculosis.
Went to the whole school platform that someone has tuberculosis.
They said someone,
his name with student ID. They asked him to go home. That's break of like confidentiality.
Yeah,
break of confidentiality.
It's China. They are coming to say they don't care, but they don't have the same laws like we have or something. They don't know
the rules
or something.
But not to us
because we are foreigners. They don't really give a crap about any foreigner here or something. If something bad, you do something bad or something, you have this disease or that disease, they'll send in every group in the WeChat or something to tell you, okay, this student is this. The number, where is he from, everything, all the information. Like,
passport.
There's no such thing.
Everything. And it's not fair. It's really not fair.
I don't know. They don't do the same with Chinese students because I never saw anything, any Chinese student that had any disease or something.
They would never post it.
No.
Never be posted.
What is that? In this world, bad news really sells.
It does sell.
Okay. So if like you've heard the news or the rumors that someone is having HIV, ask yourself, what's the source of it? How can a hospital release someone's medical report outside to the general public that this person has an HIV? And from the source of that post, the person just typed in something on the internet and just
posted
an
information.
You know?
Yeah.
So he just alleged that he has like HIV AIDS and everything, you know? But how true is it? How true is it?
Like people know him, people see his videos and everything, so maybe there are the people who try to put themselves out there too, and they just try to frame him. I mean, like, no one can know if he has it or not, like, but himself.
But another thing is also how he handled it. He respectfully just declined it and said, this is just wrong. There could have been another way. He could have hashed out this whole situation, get angry about it, go crazy. One thing with foreigners, when you get in China, do not lose control. That's one thing. If you lose control, you'll be in big trouble because we're foreigners here. We're not safe, like, and secured in a way that you think we are. We're not really, like, protected. So you be careful of your actions no matter what Chinese do to you. Just be careful and think before you act. Really think before you act. Even if they accuse you of something, just be like, okay, take it one step at a time. Think about what you need to do before you just do it. Alright.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you for watching this channel. This is
Manuel Ross.
Right.
Spotlight Media.
And
Rondo.
Okay. Thank you for watching, Jules.